For anyone who's been lucky to dive when the spider crabs are congregating, they'll see like big smooth rays cruising around looking for soft crab. That's essentially what they're trying to get away from, or at least we think so. The spider crabs come together to do what's called moulting. The spider crabs have a hard shell and it acts a bit like an armor. They have to actually shed their shells and then they sort of pump themselves full of water and they harden a new shell on top of their bodies. And at that stage, they're soft and vulnerable to predators. That's one theory of why they come together is to seek safety in numbers. Our understanding of the species is just so basic. We don't even know, you know, how the spider crabs mate and when they mate. We don't have population numbers. We don't know how many crabs come together during moulting time and whether that varies through time naturally or as a result of human activities. Through, you know, being in the water, doing scientific surveys and the citizen science aspects of it as well. We could be discovering just about anything. Potentially, they're bringing a source of food at a time where water temperature is lower, so food availability is lower. You know, understanding the species better can help us understanding their requirement and what we need to safeguard the future of their incredible gatherings. The spider crabs live all the way along the Great Southern Reefs. Potentially aggregations can be found anywhere. So what really worries me is how little we know about the life on the Great Southern Reef. But it is challenging to get funding outside of, oh, there's a problem, we need research to fix it, just before there's a problem, to accumulate that knowledge and get to understand these species. It's just really challenging to get there. Having spider crabs in shallow waters, you know, you can see them sometimes from the beach or from the piers. I think it's very special. People really take ownership of things like that, this natural phenomenon that happens nowhere else in the world. It fascinates the local community. It generates tourism at a time where in winter, you know, tourism is lower. I guess it's a bit of a game as well and a bit of a competition that they want to be the first to know where they are or the first to understand their movements. So yeah, having people like that is just invaluable for our research. They jump in the cold water, you know, they go and look for the crabs. That's just great.